Good morning and happy Friday. Thanks for waking up with us here on KSNT News. Always good to end the week with Dr. Farley from Washburn University. Good morning.
Well, thank you. Great day to be here. Summer solstice, longest day of the year. What a great time to be in Topeka.
Absolutely. And thank you for being here this morning. I know it's early. Now, let's start out first with an update on the DeJuan Simmons case, of course, and not a ton of updates, of course, for the time being. Are you afraid that this case is going to go cold?
Oh, I'm not concerned about that at all. Topeka Police and the Chief of Police for Topeka, they are working on this, I'm certain, every day, and they do a great job. We have absolute confidence in them and in being able to provide security around not only the campus but all over the city. So we're big supporters of Topeka Police. And we then have been working with this organization called JUMP.
Yes.
It's been around for a while, been around across the country, and they've had great success. And what they're trying to do is to prevent things from happening rather than reacting to them when they happen.
Yeah. Okay.
So if we can provide housing, if we can provide jobs, if we can provide opportunity for people that have otherwise an opportunity to go bad, then we can make a real dent in the community.
Absolutely.
And we have a lot of students that will be involved in it as soon as they get back. We're setting up committees. We've been involved with Safe Streets.
Yes.
And we've been involved with Councilwoman Heller because this is her district that DeJuan lost his life. And so a lot of things happening. You just can't let it stop, though.
No, you can't, and it's great to see you doing something positive because of such a terrible tragedy. And you've probably seen Dr. Farley in several of our commercials. You've been in a media campaign. You came in for some of that.
So
you have, you know.
Okay.
Imagine. Okay, so lots going on right now at Washburn. We've had you all over the news this morning.
Good.
One big thing, though, we have to note is the ribbon-cutting ceremony today for the Washburn Tech facility.
It is an amazing thing that has happened there. There have been people that have talked about this, I'm told, for decades. Why we don't have some educational opportunities for people that live on the east side of Topeka. And it just hasn't happened, and I don't know why it hasn't happened, but everything finally came together a year or two ago, and funding was there. We found a piece of property, worked with JADO, worked with the Go Topeka, worked with the city, and came up with a plan to renovate a building and then start offering classes. We got a little behind when we had some problems with the contractor, but we started offering classes in Antioch Family Center in January.
Oh, wow, okay, yes.
So we had to do some things to get it done in January because we were hoping to open it in January. But now we're going to open today. It'll be the ribbon cutting. And, you know, this really fits in what I just said a moment ago. What JUMP is trying to do is to prevent things from happening by giving people opportunity to take their life in a different direction.
Yes.
That's what's going to happen at Topeka East. It's going to be just a great thing.
And we thank you so much for your involvement in that. Well, we're out of time. Of course, I know Dr. Farley's a big supporter, too, of that Sunflower.
Music Festival.
Go to it. It lasts all week.
Free.
So it's free. It's definitely going to be a good show. So thank you so much for being here this morning.
Good to be here.